Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Love Starter, and welcome to my Insider's Update. In today's update, we're going to talk about the new Google Analytics. That is the new Google Analytics 4 properties. We're also going to look at a great little update in Google Tag Manager, and I'm also going to give a quick plug to my Google Analytics Challenge, which started this week. Okay, let's jump into my Insider's Update. Google announced the release of a new version of Google Analytics called Google Analytics 4 Properties, which were previously called App and Web Properties. This new type of property was actually released last year, but this new announcement means they're becoming the new default in Google Analytics. Apart from changing the name from App and Web to Google Analytics 4, or GA4 for short, Google has also updated the reporting menu, added standard reports, and made it easier to connect these properties to Google BigQuery. Let's head to Google Analytics to take a quick look at these updates. Okay, I'm in my Google Analytics 4 demo property, and we can see the new reporting menu on the left. Before the update, the menu was divided into reports and events. We can see the reports are now divided into lifecycle, user, and events. You'll find default reports for how people are finding your website or app under acquisition. Details about the pages, screens, and other actions people are taking are under engagement. Revenue and purchase details are under monetization, and then we can see the retention report. Now let's select admin. I wanted to mention that it is easy to link your Google Analytics 4 property to Google BigQuery. You can now find the linking option in the property column. This is optional, but linking to BigQuery means you can store a copy of the raw event data from Google Analytics. The new Google Analytics is also focusing more on machine learning, so if you meet the minimum requirements, you'll also be able to access new predictive metrics that aren't available in your existing Universal Analytics properties. If you previously set up an App and Web property in Google Analytics, then you don't need to do anything to start using the new version of Google Analytics. And if you do want to get started with the new Google Analytics 4 properties, then check out my App and Web property resources in the description below this video. I will be updating these in the future, but apart from the changes to the reports, the steps to get up and running haven't really changed. And if you have been using Google Analytics for a while, then check out my Google Analytics Property Type Cheat Sheet, which provides a quick comparison of Google Analytics 4 and Universal Analytics properties. You can find a link to this in the description below the video. There's also a great little update to Google Tag Manager that I want to show you. So let's head to Google Tag Manager to take a look. You can now make bulk changes to your tags, triggers, and variables. For example, if you're managing your tags, you can select multiple tags. You can then pause them and unpause them, add them to folders, and delete them. Making changes in bulk is a great update to Google Tag Manager. You can also make changes in bulk to your triggers and variables. And apart from bulk changes, you can now search inside your container. This makes it easier to find what you're looking for in Google Tag Manager. Finally, I want to give a quick plug to my 2020 Google Analytics Challenge. I'm sharing simple, actionable tips on how to apply your Google Analytics reports. I'm covering a different set of reports each week. You can find a link to sign up in the description below this video. I hope you'll join me for my Google Analytics Challenge. And as always, if you found this video helpful, then please like it so I know to make more videos like this. See you next time.